congratulations. That was a heck of a game and quite a feather in your team's cap after falling behind by 10 with 4.5 minutes to play in the first half. You cut it down to 3 going into the break. Had to be a big part of the game for Bellarmine.
Big part of the game. I could break the game down, and it would be easy to say, you know, they outshot us. They out-rebounded us. I could go say all those things. We won this game because of an incredible group of young men that all wanted the same thing and were willing to do whatever it took, if it was rebound, draw a charge, run, to achieve their goal. Now, you know, it is hard to look at the 40 points in the paint. That's why they shot 54%. I mean, there's no question, because they only shot 27 from the three. I mean, but
and I know the game's 40 minutes long, but they got a bunch of those in the last 2.5 minutes. Then they're just shooting layups. We couldn't stop them.
But you know, we just didn't want to foul a jump shooter.
Yeah,
and that was scouting. They do. They kick legs. We know all that. We didn't want to foul a jump shooter. So I'll take the blame there. You know, when everybody wants the same thing, it's incredibly powerful. Probably where the game's won is we got 58 shots and they only got 50.
Yeah.
And we go 9-13 on the line and they go 11-18. That's probably the game.
Which is the turnover difference.
Yes.
So, I mean.
No. I mean, when you win on the road, now you go to 3-0 in the league. And now you keep learning when you're successful. That's been our motto, and give them credit. Like Kurt Hope, he goes 3 for 5. He goes 6 points, 4 rebounds. Or 3 rebounds, he gets fouls. But look at Kurt. Now, he's never played a road conference game.
Yeah.
You know, and I am concerned. We played 3 guys 38 minutes. That's a lot of minutes. But, like, you know, Ethan's getting back. He played 25
boy,
minutes.
Isn't he?
And he's helping. You know, you think about this, though. CJ, it's amazing. It is unbelievable.
Yeah.
But, you know, like, if we took everybody in this facility tonight, they listed it at 3,000 and change, and we just started saying, let's choose a pickup game, you know what? His team's going to win. His team's going to win. They always win. That's what they do.
Dylan came through again with 15 of his 25 in the second half, and should point out here, he's over 1,000 points now, too, in his career. Just went over it today, needed 23, and ended up with 25, so you'll have to find a ball somewhere.
We've got delivery or supply problems. We will go do that in the locker room right now, trust me.
So he's over 1,000 points for his career and backed up that 38-point effort with a big game again today.
Lipscomb, they're hard to play. They're hard to play because you have to beat them. They don't beat themselves. Now, we force some turnovers, but they beat you, and they have a plan, and, I mean,
pretty much took the big man out of the game again.
Yeah. Lenny A. Cup is a heck of a basketball coach. Forget this league. Nationwide, he is a heck of a basketball coach. I go back when he was at Alabama Huntsville and I was at Bellarmine. Lenny A. Cup is a great basketball coach. He's not a good basketball coach. And I'm not BSing. I don't do that. That we beat a Lenny A. Cup coach team is a tremendous credit to our players in this program, believe me.
Asajula scored 10, but only took 7 shots. You doubled him a lot.
We had different ways, though. We did double, but different ways.
So, kind of, can you elaborate a little bit on what?
Well, just on when we didn't want to let him get into a rhythm against us, so we practiced it, changing up different looks.
You had to be pretty sad. I can only remember a couple of back doors that they
got. We got one, I know.
Yeah.
Alec. Alec was so – the reason I know – I'm not throwing Alec under the bus, because he was madder at himself than I was. He was. And we stressed it. You know, we stressed it for 3 days. But I'll tell you this. This game was won the first three four-minute wars of the second half. This game was won.
Yeah.
I mean, that's where this game was won. And Doug, what you said, the end of the first half and then the first three wars of the second half, this game was won.
7-0 on the road now in Ace on play.
Yeah.
How about that? That's not too many teams around the league, no matter what league you're playing in, can do that.
And there's nothing better. You guys have been involved in. There's nothing better than that ride home from a road win. And, you know, we're going to enjoy this tonight. We're going to go celebrate Dylan. I'm going to go in there right now and announce it to him. I wouldn't wear that. We'll go do that right now.
The Next week is at home, so that's a good thing. North Alabama, by the way, we can give you some scores here. They lost today in overtime at Central Arkansas, 89-88. Kennesaw State looks to be an improved team this year. They had an easy win at Stetson, 77-49, and Battle of Jacksonville went to the Dolphins over the North Florida Ospreys, 54-51. So Jacksonville looks to be improved,
too. Yeah, we got Liberty tonight playing.
Yeah, Liberty plays FGCU. At
Florida Gulf Coast.
Yeah. Right, and Jack State is at Eastern Kentucky. So right. Jacksonville looks to be improved, too, at
no question.
3-0 in the league now, and the new coach.
Coaching
matters.
Coaching big home matter. Games. And, yeah. Get ready, guys. I'm going to be trying to beg you to come. Get ready. Day Saturday. We're going to try to beg you. Tuesday and Saturday night, 7 o'clock. Come on. They deserve it, man. Yeah.
Well,
thank you, guys.
Go celebrate with Dylan here. Thank you, Scott.